Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have another Falcon 9 launch to kick off this episode as well as other SpaceX information. As always, it's then Boca Chica infrastructure and Starship development progress as well as SN8 which should fly soon. Let's head straight in and get up to date. As you may already know, SpaceX launched the GPS-free Space Vehicle 4 satellite on Thursday using a brand new booster. B-1062, which flew this mission, then landed successfully on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Touchdown of our Falcon 9 on Of Course I Still Love You. And again, that did happen at the same time, so we did have SECO and good orbit of our second stage.
NASA Commercial Crew tweeted a cool shot of Crew Dragon in the hangar at LC-39A after arriving recently. In just a week from now, this capsule should launch the Crew 1 mission with 4 astronauts. There was a tweet from a Canadian Twitter account saying the regulatory approval for Starlink has been granted. With SpaceX not only getting ready to launch astronauts for the second time very soon, they are also preparing for their next cargo mission. NASA posted an article which says, NASA and SpaceX currently are targeting no earlier than 12:50 PM Eastern Time on Wednesday, December 2nd for the CRS-21 launch. We have some more launch information with this tweet from Kathy Luders about the delayed Sentinel 6 launch. She said, we are now targeting Saturday, November 21st for the launch of the US-European Sentinel 6. Having covered those updates, it's over to Boca Chica now, starting with the launch area. Engineers have been seen doing further work on the suborbital launch mount at Pad B. Mary got this great shot of the orbital launch mount currently being constructed and the new tent they've put up nearby. There's been some further work with the ground inside the area with more concrete being poured. Recently, some new pieces arrived on the back of a trailer over at the launch area. Some further pipe-looking parts were seen on another trailer and were unloaded. Talking about new arrivals, in the construction yard a new piece for something was also seen sitting on the back of a trailer. In the production area again, there were even more components that have arrived on a trailer. The high bay which is being built to house Super Heavy as it's stacked has continued to be worked on inside and out. Now, taking a look at some Starship bits and pieces, we have a new thrust puck with a slightly different design sitting behind some stuff. Here's another closer look at this new puck design. It's been a while since we've seen anything from Rafael Adami, but he recently posted this cool new diagram. He tweeted it with the caption, possibly a new puck design for SN12 Plus. The methane manifold seems to be external now with the methane downcomer attached to the inverted cone. There's also other pieces spotted here and there with this barrel section outside in the yard. SpaceX's old fairing section was recently painted as a lunar lander mock-up nose but has been seen moving. It was also hooked up to a crane in order to be lifted again and moved elsewhere. They moved it onto a new stand by the fabrication tent. We have a two-ring stack out in the yard that has also been moved elsewhere. Behind the tent by the windbreaker, a tapered section for a nose cone was lifted and placed on a mount. Moving on, we have SN8, and last episode we saw some testing with them successfully testing the nose cone liquid oxygen header tank. Parts of the main tank were also seen with some frost on them during the testing window. That testing was in preparation for their planned 15km flight soon. Since then, engineers have been continuing to work on SN8. They've been seen also doing work underneath the prototype, I assume with the Raptor engines that will propel this beast. Here's a look at the road and beach closures posted by Cameron County with dates we can expect testing. They originally had a window from 7 PM local time tonight, but that has since been cancelled. However, there's a bunch of other dates for the static fire and flight to potentially happen with November 9th to 13th. Hopefully, we are now just around the corner from this historic event. Moving on, we also have SN9, which is the next candidate for Starship testing after SN8 and is currently being constructed in the high bay. A crane was spotted moving into the high bay to join SN9. Could this potentially be to stack the nose cone? Finally for this video, we also have the SN11 Starship, which is also playing catch up. This mid-liquid oxygen stack for serial number 11 was seen being moved out of a tent. Then they lifted this ring stack and moved it into the mid bay as they look to soon start stacking this prototype. Here's another view of that section sitting in the mid bay, and you can't see it, but just beside it is the recently stacked SN10 tank. The very final thing to show is another cool diagram from Brendan Lewis. Here you can see the current status of the Starship development fleet along with the first Super Heavy booster and its pieces. As is always the case, thanks to Mary or Boca Chica Girl who goes out there every day to film this awesome footage. Also, hosting live streams and doing all sorts of other cool stuff behind the scenes is the NASA spaceflight team, so thanks to them as well. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.